Yeah, very good afternoon to one and all. In morning session, we see the input and output performance characteristics of the inverting schematic gate circuit. Okay, this is the circuit diagram of our inverting schematic gate circuit. In inverting schematic gate circuit, we are giving the input signal to the inverting terminal. And feedback is given to the non-inverting terminal, and again this non-inverting terminal is grounded through an external resistance R1. Here R2 is a feedback resistance. Vf is the feedback voltage or voltage at the positive terminal of this operational amplifier. We know very well always the negative terminal and positive terminal should maintain at the same potential. So the Vf value is equal to the V input value always. Okay, same V input voltage will be happened here. According to the voltage division rule, this is V naught output voltage. This entire output voltage can be distributed through the two resistances R1 and R2, and voltage across R1 resistance is Vf value, that is V input value. So this V input value is equal to R1 divided by R1 plus R2 into total output voltage V naught. Okay, we derived this formula in morning section. And if you substitute, V naught is equal to positive saturation voltage and V input is equal to upper threshold voltage. We get upper threshold voltage VUT is equal to positive V saturation into R1 by R1 plus R2. If you substitute V naught as positive saturation value and V input as upper threshold voltage value, yet if the input voltage reaches the upper threshold voltage value, up to that instant, the voltage is output voltage is positive saturation value. That's why we substitute V naught as positive saturation value, V in as upper threshold value. So the formula for upper threshold value is this thing. Next, we can substitute output voltage as negative saturation value, negative V saturation, and input voltage is lower threshold voltage. If the input reaches the lower threshold value, output voltage is maintained as negative saturation value. So that's why the lower threshold voltage VLT is equal to minus V saturation into R1 by R1 plus R2. If you substitute these two terms in equation 1, we get this thing. So we get the formulas for upper threshold value and lower threshold value. If you substitute those two things in hysteresis band or dead band is equal to upper threshold voltage minus lower threshold voltage. We get finally the hysteresis width or dead band is equal to 2 times of V saturation into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Up to these things we discussed in the morning session, but we didn't discuss the transfer characteristics of our inverting schematic trigger circuit. So this is the transfer characteristics. The meaning of transfer characteristics is generally the waveforms are plotted with respect to the magnitude and the time period. Okay, this is the input waveform, this is upper saturation voltage, this is lower saturation voltage, this is the output voltage. All these things are plotted with respect to the variation of time period. But the transfer characteristics are plotted with respect to the variation of input voltage from lower threshold value to upper threshold value. How the output is varied in the concept of transfer characteristics, we are plotted the output response of our schematic trigger circuit with respect to the variation of input voltages. If the input voltage is varying from a lower threshold value to upper threshold value, how the output is changing, that can be plotted in our transfer characteristics. Okay, so if you see here, this is the input waveform. Okay, that input waveform is varying alternatively from zero value to positive maximum value, again zero value, negative maximum value, zero value. Okay, so the maximum range or maximum variation of the input voltage is from positive maximum value to negative maximum value. So the input voltage value, actually the input voltage value can be varying from negative maximum value to whatever it may be, an alternating signal, sine wave of a negative maximum value to positive maximum value. These are the limits of input voltage magnitude. Okay, so let me analyze. If the waveform is input waveform is varying from maximum to positive maximum to negative maximum, or zero to positive maximum, zero negative maximum to zero, how the output can vary? Okay, so this is the input. We are taking the input values on the x-axis. Initially the input voltage is zero, so at this instant initially input voltage is zero and the input voltage value is gradually goes on increasing, like this goes on increasing and reaches some upper threshold voltage point. This is upper threshold voltage point. So the input voltage waveform is varying from zero voltage to the upper threshold voltage. Up to this instant, the input voltage value is lesser than the upper threshold voltage. So in this duration of time period, the upper threshold voltage value is lesser than the input voltage value is lesser than the upper threshold voltage value. At that instant, the output is positive saturation plus V saturation. So during the time of variation of input voltage from zero value to upper saturation value, the output voltage value is positive saturation, like this. So this is the positive saturation voltage level. This is positive saturation voltage level and this is negative saturation voltage level. So the voltage is in the range of zero to upper threshold voltage value. The output voltage is positive as shown in this output waveform. So in our transfer characteristics also, the output voltage maintained as positive up to the input value reaches the upper threshold value from zero value. Okay, next I will further increase the input voltage value from upper threshold voltage value to the maximum value. So further the input voltage value is increasing from this upper threshold value to maximum value. What is output voltage? Output voltage is negative saturation value. Because of here, the input voltage value is greater than the upper saturation value. All these input voltages are greater than the upper saturation values. That's why the output magnitude is negative saturation as indicated here. So during the time of input voltage is varying from upper threshold voltage value to maximum value, the input voltage is greater than the upper threshold voltage value and the output voltage value is negative as shown up to here. Okay, Next, what happened when the output is reaches, when the input is reaches the maximum value, then again the input is decreasing slowly. So the voltage is decreasing first, the input is starting from zero, it will reaches upper saturation value, further it is increased up to the maximum value, and after that again it will decreases from maximum value to upper saturation voltage value, maximum value to upper threshold value. During this time also V input is greater than upper threshold value, so the output is negative saturation. Further it will decreases to lower threshold voltage value, from positive maximum to upper threshold value to zero value. So it will reaches the zero value and again it will decreases up to lower threshold voltage value. So from this upper threshold voltage value to lower threshold voltage value, the output is maintained as negative saturation value. So the output is maintained as negative saturation value till the input voltage reaches the lower threshold voltage value. From upper threshold voltage value, the output is maintained as negative saturation up to this instant. Okay, whenever it will reaches the lower threshold value, it can shift the output from negative saturation value to positive saturation value. Whenever the input signal is reaching the lower threshold value, up to that instant output is negative saturation. Whenever the input voltage rises or greater than the lower threshold voltage value, if the input voltage is greater than the lower threshold value, it will change its state from negative saturation value to positive saturation value. So the value is changing from negative to positive output voltage value. Okay, next, this state of positive saturation can be maintained, output as positive saturation can be maintained up to the input waveform reaches the upper threshold voltage value. So we further increasing the voltage magnitude, up to negative maximum value. After negative maximum value, the voltage waveform, input voltage waveform again decreases and it reaches zero. Again, it will reaches the upper threshold value. Up to that instant, the voltage magnitude, output voltage magnitude is maintained as positive saturation value like this. So these are the and again it will reaches the upper threshold voltage value, again same thing will repeat, okay, and so on. So finally the output voltage is varying as positive saturation value and negative saturation value by varying our input waveform from negative maximum value to positive maximum value. Okay, so this thing will continuously happen. So this is, sorry, okay, this is the transfer characteristics of our inverting schematic trigger circuit. Okay, I think ardhamayindamma transfer characteristics ela plot chesamo. Transfer characteristics always represent the variation of output voltage with the variation of input voltages. Okay, generally the input voltage is varying from positive maximum to negative maximum, or it can be specially varied from lower threshold voltage to upper threshold value, or this is the negative maximum value, this is positive maximum value. Okay, if you analyze from zero instant of thing, from zero, or you can analyze from lower upper threshold value also, this is upper threshold value. At upper threshold value, the output voltage is negative saturation, up to it reaches lower threshold value. So the negative saturation value is maintained from upper threshold voltage to lower threshold value. From lower threshold value to some maximum value, it will reaches positive waveform. From this lower threshold value to maximum value, maximum value to upper threshold voltage value, the output is positive saturation. So from lower threshold voltage to maximum value and maximum value to again upper threshold voltage value, the output is positive saturation value. Okay, for after reaching the upper threshold value, the waveform, the output waveform again shifts from positive saturation value to negative saturation value. So same thing will be happen. This width, the difference between upper threshold voltage to lower threshold voltage is called as dead band or hysteresis width. Okay, so we derive the formula for this hysteresis band also. The hysteresis width or dead band is equal to 2 into V saturation into R1 by R2. And you remember this, always the upper threshold voltage value and lower threshold voltage value is depends upon the saturation voltage and resistance values R1 and R2, input resistance and feedback resistance values. So this is the concept of inverting schematic trigger circuit. The difference between zero crossing detector to the schematic trigger circuit is, in zero cross detecting circuit, the output waveform is same thing, square waveform, but the instants of positive and negative peaks are at the time of crossing the zero magnitude of input voltages. But here the positive saturation value and negative saturation values, nothing but positive and negative peaks of output waveform can be changing depends upon upper threshold voltage value and lower threshold voltage value. From upper threshold voltage value to lower threshold value, the output is negative saturation. From lower threshold voltage to upper threshold value, the output is positive saturation. So here the width of positive and negative peaks can be decided by the upper and lower threshold values, and the magnitude of upper and lower threshold values is depends upon resistance values and saturation voltage values. So this is the concept of inverting schematic trigger circuit. We already said the schematic trigger circuits are classified into two types. Those are inverting schematic trigger circuit and non-inverting schematic trigger circuit. So we directly go with the concept of second concept of non-inverting schematic trigger circuit. So this is the circuit diagram of our non-inverting schematic trigger circuit. So the name itself, it is non-inverting schematic trigger circuit. So that's why we are applying an alternating supply, AC supply, to the non-inverting terminal, means positive terminal. And the another inverting terminal is directly connected to the ground as shown in this figure. So in the concept of non-inverting schematic trigger circuit, the input voltage Vin of sinusoidal supply is directly connected through our non-inverting terminal, means positive terminal, through a resistance R1. And R2 is the feedback resistance, we know very well. All the schematic trigger circuits are positive feedback connections in order to operate in regenerative mannerism. So this entire operation is regenerative operation. That's why we are using a positive feedback connection. Okay. And inverting terminal is connected to the ground. This is the output voltage. Some quantity of output is fed as the feedback to the positive terminal. Okay. But here the conditions are different. Always we know whatever the conditions in inverting scheme, that can be completely reversed in the non-inverting scheme. Okay, so in inverting scheme, we said if the input voltage is varying from upper threshold voltage to lower threshold voltage, the output is negative saturation, and the input is varying from lower threshold voltage to upper threshold voltage, the output is positive saturation waveform. But in our non-inverting schematic trigger circuit, if the input is varying from upper threshold voltage to the lower threshold voltage, the output is positive, exactly reverse to the inverting scheme. Okay, so the input waveform is varying from upper threshold voltage to lower threshold voltage, the output is positive saturation here. And the input is varying from lower threshold voltage to the upper threshold voltage, the output is negative saturation here. But the values of upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltages are changed in non-inverting schematic trigger. In inverting schematic trigger, the upper threshold voltage value is this thing, V saturation into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. The lower threshold voltage is minus V saturation into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. But in non-inverting schematic trigger, the formulas for upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage can be changed. Okay, so let me see what will be the formulas of upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage. So this is our non-inverting configuration. We know very well the voltage at the inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal should be maintained at the same values. Always in an operational amplifier, voltage at inverting terminal is equal to voltage at non-inverting terminal. Here the inverting terminal, negative terminal, is fed with the zero voltage supply. It is directly connected to the ground. So the voltage available at this negative terminal is zero. So same zero voltage can be available at the non-inverting terminal, positive terminal. Okay. So VF value is equal to zero here because of input to the inverting terminal inverting terminal is zero. That's why VF value is zero. Okay. So what will be the voltage across R1 and R2 resistance? Or if you assume some input current is flows from this alternating supply, some input current I is flowing from the input. Okay. And we know very well the current through the inverting and non-inverting terminals is also zero. So 0 amperes of current is flowing through the positive terminal. And IF feedback current value is flowing through the RF resistance or R2 resistance. But here there is no current is divided to the positive terminal. That's why the input current value is equal to feedback current value. The current flowing through the R1 resistance is always equal to the current flowing through the R2 resistance. What is formula for current flowing in R1 resistance? Potential difference divided by resistance. What is potential difference here? V input minus zero divided by R1. Okay. Next, what is current? Feedback current value zero minus V naught is V naught divided by feedback resistance R2. So the current formulas are VI divided by R1, which is equal to minus V naught divided by R2. Okay. So from these formulas, we can estimate the value of upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltages. Okay. So this is the expression from the circuit diagram. Iin is equal to IF. Iin value is V input minus 0 divided by R1, 0 minus V naught divided by R2. From this, the input voltage expression, V input is equal to minus R1 divided by R2 into V naught. The input voltage value of our non-inverting schematic trigger, Vin is equal to minus R1 by R2 into output voltage value V naught. Okay. So if you see the waveforms, if the input voltage value is equal to the upper saturation value, the input value is varying from zero to upper threshold value, the output is negative saturation. Whenever the input is varying from zero value to upper threshold voltage value, the output is negative saturation. So V naught is negative saturation up to the instant of input voltage reaches upper threshold voltage. So let me substitute these terms. The output voltage value is minus V saturation value up to the instant of input voltage reaches the upper threshold value. So substitute V input as upper threshold voltage, V output as minus V saturation values, then we get upper threshold voltage VUT is equal to minus of minus, in V naught place we have to substitute minus V saturation, into R1 divided by R2. So upper threshold voltage is equal to R1 by R2 into V saturation value. Okay, if you see further analysis, the input value is varying from upper threshold voltage to lower threshold voltage. Okay, the output waveform is positive saturation. Okay, up to the instant of input voltage reaching the lower threshold voltage value, the output is maintained as positive saturation value. So the output value is positive saturation value whenever the input reaches the lower threshold value. So substitute V input is equal to lower threshold value, V naught is equal to positive saturation value in this expression. We get the lower threshold voltage is equal to minus of V saturation into R1 by R2. That is lower threshold voltage is equal to minus R1 by R2 into V saturation. You should remember these formulas for upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage. So the hysteresis width or dead zone of the transfer characteristics is V hysteresis is equal to upper threshold voltage minus lower threshold voltage. So if you substitute upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltages, R1 divided by R2 into V saturation, minus of minus is plus here, R1 by R2 into V saturation. Finally, we get the hysteresis width is 2 into R1 by R2 into V saturation. In inverting configuration, 2 into R1 divided by R1 plus R2 into V saturation. In the place of R2, you can use R1 plus R2 term. In inverting schematic trigger circuit, but in non-inverting schematic trigger circuit, the hysteresis band is 2R1 divided by R2 into V saturation only. Okay, so those are the formulas for upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage. The upper threshold voltage is R1 by R2 into V saturation value. Lower threshold voltage is minus R1 by R2 into V saturation value. Okay, and the input waveform is varying from upper threshold voltage to the lower threshold voltage. The output voltage is positive saturation value. If the input voltage is varying from lower threshold voltage to the upper threshold voltage, the output voltage is negative saturation value. So the output voltage is varying from positive saturation values to negative saturation values by way due to the variation of our input voltage from upper threshold voltage to the lower threshold voltage. So this width of the square waveform is decided by the upper and lower threshold voltages, and the value of upper and lower threshold voltages is depends upon resistance values and saturation voltage values. Saturation voltage is nothing but external biasing voltage which we are applying to our operational amplifier. Okay, so this is the output waveforms and formulas of upper and lower threshold voltages. If you see the transfer characteristics, these are the transfer characteristics. Okay, the transfer characteristics of inverting schematic trigger should be different to the non-inverting schematic trigger. Okay, if you see these transfer characteristics are completely different to the these transfer characteristics because of the conditions are different here. Exactly, we can maintain opposite conditions in inverting schematic trigger on a non-inverting schematic trigger. Okay, so if you see the transfer characteristics, again the input voltage value is varying from some negative maximum value to the positive maximum value. So this is a negative maximum value input value, and this is a positive maximum. This is a positive maximum value. In between negative maximum value and positive maximum value, we have upper threshold voltage, lower threshold voltage, and zero voltage. So in between positive maximum to negative maximum, we have upper threshold voltage, lower threshold voltage, and zero voltage. Right? Let me start at the instant of upper threshold voltage. Okay, now, or we can start from a zero instant also. So this is zero, this zero. The input waveform is varying from zero value to the upper threshold voltage, upper threshold voltage to the maximum value to the again upper threshold voltage value, again upper threshold voltage value to zero value, from zero value to lower threshold value, from lower threshold value to negative maximum value, from negative maximum value to lower threshold voltage value, lower threshold voltage value to zero value, like as shown here. Zero to upper threshold to maximum, maximum to upper threshold to zero, zero to lower threshold to negative maximum to lower threshold to zero. This is a complete cycle. So if you see the response, if the input is varying from zero to upper threshold voltage value, what should be the output? Output is negative saturation value. So the output here is negative saturation value, this thing, negative saturation value. Here the condition is input voltage is lesser than the upper threshold voltage value. Okay. Okay, so this is the output. If the input value is further increasing from upper threshold value to maximum value to zero value to lower threshold value, the input value is further increasing from upper threshold value to maximum value to upper threshold value to zero value to lower threshold value, the output waveform is shifts from negative saturation value to positive saturation value. So the output here is changing from negative saturation value to, up to this instant it is negative, it will shift from negative saturation value to positive saturation value like this up to here. And the condition is V input voltage value is greater than the upper threshold value. Here V input value is greater than the further condition, it is the general condition is V input value is greater than the upper threshold voltage value up to this instant. Okay, next further instant the input value is greater than the lower threshold voltage value. Here also here in this instant also, in this instant also, the input voltage value is greater than the lower threshold value. Lower threshold value is this negative thing. This negative thing is great. This negative thing is always lesser than the input waveform, or the input waveform is greater than this lower threshold voltage value. So the input waveform is greater than the lower threshold value, and the output is maintained as positive saturation value. Okay. Next, in further instant, the voltage is reaching the lower threshold voltage. Next, it will be increases to negative maximum, and from negative maximum to lower threshold, lower threshold to zero. So the input is varying from lower threshold voltage to negative maximum, negative maximum to lower threshold to zero. So the output is changing from positive saturation value to negative saturation value like this. Okay. And again, it is back. Okay. And the condition is V input value is lesser than the lower threshold voltage value. The output is maintained as negative saturation value. So the same thing is again and again repeat, and will produce this hysteresis band. So this is the transfer characteristics of our non-inverting schematic trigger circuit. Always the transfer characteristics are plotted, how the output voltage can be varied with respect to the input voltage. You remember this, the input voltage waveform having a prescribed range. It will definitely vary from positive maximum value to negative maximum value. And output voltage value also have the range. That range is from positive saturation value to negative saturation value. That's why we get this closed loop band. Okay, closed loop square shaped band, hysteresis band. Okay, this is our today concept of inverting schematic trigger and non-inverting schematic trigger. Only we get exact opposite waveforms in inverting schematic trigger and non-inverting schematic trigger. Whatever the waveforms we plotted, output waveforms, what are the output voltage waveforms, output square waveform we get at the non-inverting schematic trigger is exactly opposite to the inverting schematic trigger circuit. Okay, so this is about today's